Time now for Options Insight. I'm Abigail Doolittle. Joining me today from the SIBO in Chicago is Alan Nuckman of Agora Financial. Alan, great to have you with us as always. And Alan, you are my penultimate bull. My ultimate bull is technician Ari Wald. And you both have been very correct over the last couple of years in terms of buying the dip. Right. Are you buying this dip?
Yeah, I'm looking to buy the dips and sell the rips. So things haven't changed yet. I look at things on more a weekly basis, and I know we've talked about the 3,200 level in the S&P as a level of super support. We've been below that for the last session or two. So let's see what can happen today and tomorrow. Interesting action this morning where we gapped down, but then we did fill the gap after that first hour, but gave back those gains. So it has been somewhat orderly. We had 3% losses back-to-back, and it looks like today could be another 3% loss. So what's happened now is it puts a risk reward back in favor of some stocks that I like for the long term.
In this type of a situation, though, when it's so fast and furious, more than 10% in 6 days, does it take a little bit of time to stabilize, or do you even really want to see, you know, that capitulation bottom that everybody looks for? And based on what you're describing earlier today, it certainly was not it. And based on the fact that we're not in the green, not either.
Right. We didn't bounce back and keep those gains here this morning, so that still doesn't look like we have a bottom in place just yet. But we'll see. It's been a quick move over a couple days with some big gaps up above that eventually could get squeezed into. But I try and look at things from longer-term standpoint using options. So today's a good example, looking at options that have at least 3 to 6 months of time so we can ride through. Let's remember, this has only been 6 sessions since we were at all-time highs. So just last Wednesday, not yesterday, but a week ago yesterday, we were at all-time forever highs in the market. So let's see how this all sorts out.
Yeah, it's pretty extraordinary. And I would have to say you are pretty brave to be a dip buyer right now. But one area that you would be buying is outperformance on a relative basis in China, which is kind of interesting because the Asian session was actually mixed. But talk to us, which may lend hope for here in the U.S., but talk to us about your trade on JD.com.
Yeah, sure. But the point here is I'm using limited risk options. My maximum risk is whatever I pay for these options, and I'm buying plenty of time, so they're not going to evaporate in the near term. So let's look at JD.com. It's trading at 39. This stock has dropped 10% from its top in just the last couple of sessions. This has been a straight-up stock. It's still up 50% in the last 52 weeks. So if I look at this chart pattern here, it's backed off, and I can look at 34 as the midpoint of this action we've seen over the last year from 23 up to this recent high at 25 to 43. So I'm leaning on this 34 level, 34 strike, which is $5 in the money. It's like being long the stock from a super discount to where we are now. And that option's going to trade for about $7. So my break even's $2 away. I've got 4 months of time in this overall play. But let's remember, this is a super strong stock. And China was actually positive yesterday.
Yes,
and we had that sector only down 5% compared to our market down 10% in the last few days.
Yes, that's certainly worth taking note. It'll be interesting to see how all of this plays out. We'll look forward to speaking to you then. Alan Nuckman of Agora Financial, thank you for joining us for Options Insight. And Scarlett, back to you.
Abigail, thank you.